Hello and welcome to my channel. This is Trusty Rusty Depot, and today we're going to be going over how to configure Nushell. The first thing we're going to want to do is to open up Alacrity. In order to do that, we can press Command Space, type in Alacrity, and press Enter. Now we're going to need to figure out where the configuration file is stored. To do that, we can type in the command config path, and then we can take the output of this command and use the pipe symbol to redirect it into another command. This is called piping, and we can say clip, which will copy it to our clipboard, and press enter. The next thing we want to do is to open it up in our favorite editor. I'm going to use NeoVim. To use NeoVim, I'm going to type in nvim, quote, and then paste what we had before. The reason we need quotes is because there's a space, and if we didn't use quotes, Nushell would think that these are two separate command arguments. Now, if we press enter, it will open up this file for us. We can see that this file already has stuff in it because if you recall in the last video, we ran commands that set up the path for us so that all our commands previously installed would work correctly. If you haven't looked at that video, you should check it out. I'll leave a link in the top corner. Now, the first thing we probably want to do is to remove that annoying welcome message that opens up every time we open Alacrity. I'm talking about this welcome message. So if we go back to the file, to remove it, we can just add a line by pressing O and saying skip welcome message equals true, and then press escape and colon W and press enter. Then the next time we open Alacrity like this, there's no welcome message at the top. The next thing I want to show you has to do with the main feature of Nushell. The main feature of Nushell is that it displays output from most commands in table format. I'm going to show you how to customize the look of these tables. First, I'm going to show you the default look of the tables. I'm going to open Alacrity again, and I'm going to open the configuration file using the command open and quote, paste, and end quote, and then you can see that it displays the contents of the file in a structured format, and I don't really like that these edges are being cut off. So I can change that by going back to the configuration file and adding a line that says table mode equals, and I like the heavy mode. And again, save it. And then if I open Alacrity again and do the same thing as before, you can see that now the table looks different. And there are other values you can put inside here. For more information, you can visit the Nushell website, which is nushell.sh. And you can see all of the options there. The last thing I wanted to show you was how to make startup commands, which also includes aliases and functions. In order to create startup functions, you need to add a line called startup and make it equal to a pair of brackets. And in here, we can put a list of commands that we want Nushell to run on startup. The first thing we want to do is put quotes around our command that we want it to run. And then we can put the command. So if I want it to run pfetch every time I open Nushell, I can write pfetch there and save that. And if I open Alacrity, you can see that it ran pfetch on startup. If I wanted to create an alias, I could put a comma here and then put quotes, and then I could put the alias keyword, and then, for example, I'm going to say that I want vim to be equal to nvim, so that when I run the command vim, I can run the command neovim. So if I save that and open up Alacrity again, I can run the command vim and it will open neovim for me. The last thing in startup commands is functions. To define a function, I can use the keyword def, which stands for define, and then put in the name. I'm going to name it greet, and then I'm going to put brackets. These are going to be the arguments that the function takes in. So I'm going to say name, and then braces, curly braces, and then put in what I want it to do. I can say echo, hello, and then dollar sign, because I want it to be the variable name. And then if I save that and open up Alacrity again, I can run greet test and it prints out hello test. So it works. So that's it for configuring Nushell. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next video.